podcast.
And then I listen to a bunch of podcasts. I'm only going to talk about one of them, so you'll see that in the podcast section. Many podcasts every week, and unless you actually plan on subscribing to new podcasts, like all these TV ones I listen to, Talking TV with Ryan and Ryan, the Firewall and Iceberg podcast, etc., etc., you know, I should really only be trying to find a special episode to recommend to you, I think. So this week, that episode would be Girl on Guy with Aisha Tyler talking to David Benioff, one of the co-creators, I guess, of Game of Thrones. Obviously, George R. R. Martin created it, but he was one of the guys. The other guy's name is D.B. Weiss. I think he's also a David, who really got Game of Thrones off the ground. They were the guys that read the book a little bit late and kind of said, wow, this would make a great HBO show. Their first thought wasn't movie, their first thought wasn't network show, it was HBO show. And it actually took a while to get off the ground, and I knew some of the stuff that gets covered in this podcast, like the first pilot they shot for the thing turned out horribly. They had to do a bunch of recasting, go reshoot the whole thing again, and HBO was very forgiving because, you know, as you find out talking to some people that have made it into the world of HBO, it's a very hard place to get into. Like, they pretty much have their network of writers and producers and the people they work with, and it's really hard to break into that. So they were, you know, these are guys that had written some movies, like David Benioff wrote like The 25th Hour, the book and the screenplay. You know, it was kind of like that first movie that really felt like a post 9/11 movie in New York with Edward Norton and that whole thing. But they didn't have any TV background that quite would, you know, give HBO confidence to think they could do this well. And after the first pilot, they very much could have said, you know what, we're going to cut our losses, this isn't going to work, and just could have ended it there. Some of the fascinating things that come up in the podcast that, you know, I didn't know before is that, you know, the reason they stick to a 10-episode schedule is that they are working year-round. They do not get a break. So ever since that first season started pre-production, these guys have been working nonstop since then, because they are always either writing an episode, they're casting, they're in post-production, they're gathering costumes, they're figuring out what they're going to do with the source material. Now that they've kind of surpassed where the books are, they're trying to figure out how they're going to tell the stories that haven't yet been told in the book and the best way to do that. So there's so many different things going on. And it's also nice to hear that they do have, they're aware of certain, you know, things that people feel about certain missing characters or things like that, Strong Belwas and that kind of thing, Lady Stoneheart, all that, but also that they're aware of when people think maybe they spent too much time with something. So I am in the camp that does not believe we needed to see quite so much scrotum torture for Theon Greyjoy, who then becomes Reek. In the book, you know, you basically don't see him for a while, and then suddenly he's this, you know, horrible, sad creature, and you're like, man, what happened to him? And you kind of hear about it. And personally, I think that works. You know, these guys felt that we needed to see that progression, which, you know, maybe hint at it, maybe show a scene or two, but we did not need to see a scene in pretty much every episode of last year or the year before watching that transformation. But I think it's smart, some of the things they're doing now, the fact that they're like cutting Bran out for a season, and that gives them a little bit more breathing room to focus on the other characters. And he also said something that I like, which is, you know, it's not about fitting everyone into the show, it's about giving everyone some substantial meaty plot lines to chew on and really have some good screen time with, you know. So they much rather have an episode that only focuses on three characters and gives all those characters some great scenes than an episode that has 20 characters, but each of those characters pretty much just gets like a line or two in. So that made a lot of sense. Anyway, there's a lot of great stuff in that episode. I recommend it a lot. 5 stars, confidence of 3.